Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so still in limits, we continue our lesson. So today we learn about the limits involving radical function, and another one is limit of trigonometric function. Okay. So limit of trigonometric function. So kita ada dua, okay. So tadi radical function yang ada square root tu, and then trigonometric function. So untuk limit of trigonometric function ni, dia hanya untuk x approaching to 0. Okay, so kita belajar kat sini hanya untuk x approaching to 0. Okay, ha, nanti kenapa sebab dia adalah, okay. Okay, so for the radical function. Okay, so in radical function there are three form. Okay, so first form I already teach you in the previous video. Okay, so but I repeat again here. Okay, so for the form, so we have square root and then minus something here and over something. So for example, so limit x approaching to a number. Okay, so let's say 0. Okay, so square root x minus 4 plus 4 divided by x. Okay, okay, so contoh. So square root x minus 4. So we have square root and then here plus. And then limit x approaching to 1. 1 minus square root x over x minus 1. Okay. So ni pun boleh jadi. So dia square root dekat belakang, dekat depan ada sesuatu nombor. Okay, so boleh jadi. Okay, so method we use here, so we use rationalized expression by multiplying with conjugate on numerator and denominator. Okay, so numerator and denominator ni atas dengan bawah kita darabkan dengan conjugate. Okay, so kenapa kita darabkan dengan conjugate? Sebabnya if you substitute 0 into x, for example this one. Okay, so actually this one plus. Okay, so x plus 4. Okay, so if you substitute 0, so 0 plus 4 become square root 4 and here minus. Okay, so minus 2, not minus 4. Okay, so minus 2 divided by 0. So you will have 0 over 0. Okay, so sebab korang dapat 0 per 0. Yang bawah ni pun sama. If you substitute 1, so 1 minus square root 1 over 1 minus 1. Okay, so we have 0 over 0. So kita masuklah dia punya cara dia lah, darab conjugate atas dengan bawah. Okay, so kalau yang tadi sebelum saya buat contoh yang salah tu, contoh limit square root x plus 4 plus 4 divided by x, x approaching to 0. Okay, so kalau korang buat yang ni, so you will have here 0 plus 4, so square root 4 plus 4 divided by 0. Okay, so square root 4 plus 4 is 6 divided by 0. Okay, so 6 divided by 0, so the answer is infinity. Kalau macam ni korang boleh kira, dapat jawapan, buat jawapan. Tak payah nak buat darab conjugate. So darab conjugate tu sekiranya you have 0 over 0. Okay, so for the radical function. Okay, so radical function ni kalau dapat 0 per 0, darab dengan conjugate. Kalau boleh kira, terus kira. Okay, okay, so next example here. Okay, so limit x approaching to 0. Okay, so if you substitute 0 for this one, so 0 over square root. Okay, so 9 times 0, 0, 0 plus 4 is 4 minus 4. Okay, so this one, the answer is 0 over square root 4 is 2 minus 4. So the answer is 0 divided by negative 2. So this one, the answer is 0. Okay, so dapat kosong. Okay, so dapat kosong, boleh kira, so jawapan dia kosong. So tak payah nak darab conjugate. Okay, Sekali yang lepas, saya perbetulkan yang ni rasanya video yang lepas ni. Okay, so another example. Okay, so this one. Okay, so if you substitute 0, okay, so you will have 1 over square root 9 plus 0 is 9 minus 1 over 3 over 0. So 1 over square root 9 is 1 over 3 minus 1 over 3 over 0. So this one is 0 over 0. Okay, so therefore we need to multiply with conjugate atas dengan bawah. Okay, so cumanya macam mana nak darab conjugate dalam bentuk yang atas ni numerator dalam bentuk fraction, yang bawah bukan. Okay, so yang atas tu korang kena simplify dululah. Okay. Okay, so saya buat tepi ni. So 1 over square root 9 plus x minus 1 over 3. So kat sini kita dua pecahan. So jadikan dia satu. So macam mana nak jadikan dia satu? So kita samakan pembawah. So this one times by square root 9 plus x, and this one also times by square root 9 plus x. Okay, so for the first one times by 3, and here times by 3. Okay, so we have here 3 minus square root 9 plus x over 3 square root 9 plus x. Okay. Okay, so ni yang atas. Lepas tu masukkan yang bawah. Okay, so we have here limit x approaching to 0, 3 minus square root 9 plus x over 3 square root 9 plus x over x. Okay, so kita sekarang ada 3 lapis. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so macam mana nak jadikan 2 lapis? So tengok tadi numerator yang mana? Numerator yang kan? Okay, so ni numerator. So therefore this one is numerator, and this one is the denominator. And then you can change into division. Okay, so numerator bahagikan dengan denominator. 3 minus square root 9 plus x over 3 square root 9 plus x. Okay, so dan bila ubah dalam bentuk pecah bahagi, kita ada pecahan. So nanti kat sini dia, kita boleh predict, nanti kita boleh jadikan darab. Lepas tu ubah pecahan, terbalikkan. Okay, tapi kat sini kita ada x. Okay, so this x we can written as x over 1. And then bahagi ubah jadi darab. Okay, so division change into multiplication. And then we terbalikkan pecahan ni, 1 over x. Okay, so after that, so we have here limit x approaching to 0, 3 minus square root 9 plus x over, so denominator times by x, so we have 3x square root 9 plus x. Okay, so ni baru simplify lah, baru permudahkan lah, daripada kita ada banyak layer tadi, jadi 2 layer. So 1, 2. Okay, so belum lagi darab dengan conjugate. Okay, so tapi tadi kita dah masukkan kosong. Masukkan kosong, kita dapat kosong per kosong kan. So dapat kosong per kosong, kita kena darab conjugate. So pilih conjugate. So mana satu conjugate? So we have here number and then square root. So the conjugate of this one is 3 plus square root 9 plus x. Okay, so darab. Then here also same, multiply with 3 plus square root 9 plus x. Okay, and then expand. Okay, so we have here 3 and negative square root 9 plus x. And here so we have 3 and positive 9 plus x. Okay, expand, so 3 times by 3, 9, and then 3 times positive square root 9 plus x, so positive 3 square root 9 plus x. Okay, and then negative square root 9 plus x times 3, So we have minus 3. Okay, so minus 3 square root 9 plus x. And then negative square root 9 plus x times positive square root 9 plus x. So we have negative 9 plus x. Okay, so dua benda yang sama. So square root 9 plus x times by square root 9 plus x. So dua benda yang sama. So bermaksud square root dengan square root cancel. So video yang lepas saya dah cerita kenapa, okay? So this one become negative because negative times positive. Okay, so and then for denominator ni tak payah expand pun tak apa. Okay. Okay, so yang mana nak expand ni biasanya kita expand function yang darabkan dengan dia punya conjugate. Okay, so macam ni yang atas ni conjugate dia yang ni kan. So kita darab, kita expand lah. Okay. So yang bawah ni dia tak ada conjugate. Tapi kita darabkan conjugate yang atas. Okay, so tapi yang bawah ni tak payahlah nak sangat. So yang penting ni yang atas. Okay, so limit x approaching to 0. Okay, so kenapa atas expand? Because this one. Okay, positive 3 square root 9 plus x minus 3 square root plus x. So this one become 0 lah, cancel lah, tambah, tolak. Okay, so jadi kosong. Then 9 minus 9 plus x. So this minus for all of this one, 9 plus x. So we need to expand negative. So minus 9 minus x over 3x square root 9 plus x times 3 plus square root 9 plus x. Okay. So 9 minus 9, 0. So we have limit x approaching to 0. So negative x over 3x square root 9 plus x multiply with 3 plus square root 9 plus x. Okay, so this x we can cancel. Sebab kat sini semua darab, 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 darab. Cuma tambah ni dalam bracket. So kalau tak boleh cancel, kalau macam ni x, x plus 1 ha. So ni dengan ni tak boleh cancel, okay? So kalau cancel, this one wrong. Sebab ni kat sini tambah ha. Kecuali kalau kat sini x over x, x plus 1 ha. So kat sini darab, ni darab, ni tambah ni dalam bracket ha. So this one you can cancel. Ni dengan ni boleh cancel. Yang ni tak boleh, okay? Okay, so go back, go back. Patang balik. Three plus square root 9 plus x. Okay, so ni cancel. Okay, so that you have here limit x approaching to 0 negative 1. So x dah tak ada, tinggal negative 1 lah. Sebab x is x times by 1. So we have here 3 square root 9 plus x. And then 3 plus square root 9 plus x, okay? And then substitute 0. So we have negative 1 over 3 square root 9 plus 0 is 9. Then times by another 3 plus square root 9 plus 0 is square root 9. Okay, so we have negative 1 over 3 times by 3 times by 3 plus 3 is 6. Okay. So we have here, the answer is negative 1 over 3 times 3, 9, 9, 54. Okay. Okay, so next, second form. Okay, so bentuk yang kedua. So we have only square root. Kat atas ni ada square root. Okay, so atas boleh, bawah pun boleh. So sama ada atas ataupun bawah. So dia square root sahaja dekat satu bahagian ni. Okay. Okay, so for this one, so we will use this properties. So x actually is equal to square root x power of 2. X square is also equal to square root of x power of 4. Okay, so square root x power of 2, it is equal to x power of 2. Square root is 1 over 2. So 2 times 1 over 2 is equal to x. Okay, and then x power of 2 equal to x power of 4 square root. So square root x power of 4 is equal to x power of 4 power 1 over 2. So 4 times 1 over 2 is x power of 2. Okay, so sama juga yang bawah tu. Okay, so kita akan gunakan ni lah nanti. Okay. Okay, so evaluate limit 1 minus 2x over square root x square plus 3. Okay, so sebenarnya kenapa kita pakai properties ni? Sebab dia jadi infinity over infinity. Okay, so for example, this one limit x approaching to infinity. Okay, so if you substitute infinity, so 1 minus 2 times infinity over square root infinity power of 2 still infinity plus 3. Okay, so this one you will obtain infinity over infinity. Okay, so if you obtain infinity over infinity, so you need to divide by highest power of x on denominator. Okay, so kita kena bahagi dengan x yang ada kuasa paling tinggi dekat denominator. Okay, so kita boleh tengok kat sini, paling tinggi adalah x power of 2. Okay, so x power of 2. Cumanya kat sini, bawah tu kita ada square root. Okay, so if you divide by x power of 2, so macam mana korang nak masukkan x power of 2 ni dalam square root? So sebabnya biasa kalau divide by highest power of x on the denominator, so kita akan buat x power of 2 plus 3 over x power of 2. Dia akan pecah-pecah macam ni. Tapi kat sini sebab dia ada square root, so kita tak boleh nak masuk. Oleh itu, apa yang kita kena buat? Okay, so we need to put this one also square root. Okay, okay, so therefore, so we have here limit x approaching to infinity 1 minus 2x over square root x square. Okay, so divide by square root x square plus 3 over square root x square. Okay, so it is equal to limit x approaching to infinity. Okay, so for this one, yang atas ni, okay, so square root x square, so we can simplify become x. So we have here 1 over x minus 2x over x. Then divide by, yang bawah ni tak payah nak simplify sebab kita ada square root dekat atas ni. Okay, so since here square root and here square root, okay, so we can ambil ni masuk dalam. Okay, so x square, so x square over x square plus 3 over x square. Okay, and then it is equal to x approaching to infinity 1 over x minus, so 2x over x become 2 over square x square divided by x square 1 plus 3 over x square. Okay, and then substitute infinity, so this one become 0 and this one also become 0. So we have here negative 2, okay, 0 minus 2 over square root 1. Okay, so which is equal to negative 2. Okay, okay, so 1 plus 0. Okay, okay, so again here. Okay, so limit x approaching to negative infinity. Okay, so if you substitute negative infinity. So we have here 3 square root 9 negative infinity power of 2 minus 1 over 6 times negative infinity plus 5. Okay, so we have here 3 negative infinity power of 2, so become positive lah. So negative power of 2 positive, so positive infinity times by 9 infinity minus 1 still infinity. Okay, and then square root infinity, infinity lah, over 6 times negative infinity, so still negative infinity plus 5. Okay, so you have here 3 times infinity, okay, become more big, so infinity, negative infinity plus 5, okay, so still infinity. Okay, so we have here infinity over infinity. So what we need to do if infinity over infinity, so we need to divide by highest power of x on denominator. So highest power of x here is x power of 1. Okay, so we have here 3 square root 9 x power of 2 minus 1 over x over 6x plus 5 over x. Okay, so yang atas ni nanti kita nak buat 9x square per yang ni dan minus 1 over this one. But here kita tak boleh buat sebab kat sini kita ada square root, kat bawah tak ada. So apa kita boleh buat? So x actually is equal to square root of x square. Okay, so kita boleh letak lah square root of x square. Okay, and then it is equal to limit x approaching to negative infinity. So 3 square root. Okay, so sebab square root square root. Okay, so kita boleh masuk lah. So sini ni darab lah. So jadi tak adalah 3 over square root x square. Okay, so sebab ada square root, so kita ambil ni masuk dalam yang ni sahaja. Okay, so become 9x square over x square minus by 1 over x square. So over 6x over x plus 5 over x. Okay, so we have here. So equal to limit x approaching to negative infinity. So 3 square root 9x square over x square. So 9 minus 1 over x square over 6 plus 5 over x. Okay, and then okay, so another one actually, okay, so satu lagi saya tertinggal. So sebab kita ada negative, so negative infinity ni kalau ada, kalau positive infinity tak ada masalah lah. Tapi sebab negative, so because of negative, so this x we need to put negative. So x dekat bawah ni kena letak negative. Okay, so become negative and here negative. Okay, so then we have here negative 6. Okay, so 6x divided by negative x, so become negative 6, and then positive plus 5 over negative x, so this one become negative. Okay, so dia jadi tolak. Okay, and then substitute the negative infinity, so this one become 0 and this one also become 0. So the answer is 3 square root 9 minus 0 over negative 6 minus 0. So the answer is 3 square root 9 is 3 over negative 6. So we have here negative 3 over 2. Okay, so lagi satu pun, kalau tak nak hafal yang ni, kita boleh check daripada sini. So it is actually positive, negative, positive infinity and negative infinity. So positive and negative, so the symbol should be negatif. Okey. So therefore, jawapan korang dekat bawah ni ada negatif 3/2. Okey, so jawapan dia last kena darab dengan negatif lah. Okey. Okay, so next, last form. So last form, we have nth root all of this fraction. Okay, so kita ada nth root semua kat dalam. Okay, semua ni ada dekat dalam nth root ni. Okay, so untuk yang ni mudahlah sikit. So move the limit inside the radical. So kita masukkan simbol limit ni ke dalam radical. So radical ni akan jadi kat luar lah. So nanti akan jadi nth root limit x approaching to positive infinity or negative infinity. So something here and here. Okay. And then divide the numerator and denominator with highest degree of x in denominator. Okay. So yang ni sebabnya infinity over infinity. Okay. So example this one. So we have here cube root. Okay, so this cube root we can take in to the outside. So limit put inside. Okay, 2 minus 3x plus 5x square over 1 plus 8x square. Okay, so if you substitute infinity. Okay, so we have cube root 2 minus 3 times infinity plus 5 times infinity over 1 plus 8 times infinity. Okay, so ke atas ni nombor tambah nombor sangat besar, nombor sangat besar become nombor yang sangat besar infinity. So yang bawah ni pun sama infinity. So kita dapat infinity over infinity. So therefore what we need to do, okay, so divide with the highest power of x on the denominator. Okay, so highest power of x on the denominator is x square. Okay, so we have 2 over x square minus 3x over x square plus 5x square over x square. Okay, so nak terus buat macam ni pun boleh, tak ada masalah. And then divide by 1 over x square plus 8x square over x square. Okay, so buat macam ni boleh, tapi metode dia betul lah, konsep dia kena betul lah. Kalau konsep salah, still tetap salah. Okay, so it is equal to cube root limit x approaching to infinity. So 2 over x square, so yes, 3x over x square, so 3 over x, then 5x square over x square plus 5 divided by 1 over x square plus 8x square over x square, so 8 lah. Okay, okay, so then it is equal to, okay, substitute infinity, so this one become 0, this one also become 0, and this one also become 0. So we have here cube root of 0 minus 0 plus 5 over 0 plus 8. Okay, so therefore we have here cube root of 5 over 8. Okay, so ni cube root ni boleh agihkan dekat atas boleh, dekat bawah sebab dia untuk semua. So we have here cube root of 5 over cube root of 8, which is 2. Okay, so itulah jawapan dia. Okay, itu sahaja. Okay, so konsep dia kalau radical ni dekat semua ni, so kita boleh bawa keluar. Okay, and then infinity over infinity tu, kalau dapat infinity over infinity, so kita kena darab highest power of the denominator. Okay, okay, so infinity over infinity, so what we do, divide numerator and denominator with highest power of x on denominator. And then if you have 0 over 0, so what you will do, so simplify or multiply with conjugate. Okay, so multiply with conjugate on numerator and denominator. Okay, so if you doesn't have this two form, kalau tak dapat infinity over infinity or 0 over 0, so tak payahlah buat. Okay, so kalau boleh kira. Okay, so yang ni untuk infinity over infinity and 0 over 0. Okay, so yang ni tadi infinity over infinity tadi untuk yang radical function tu untuk second form and third form lah. Okay, yang first form tu di dekat bawah ni darab dengan conjugate. Okay, okay, so nanti korang fahamkan lah ni. Okay, so next, limits of trigonometric function. So properties that we'll use here is limit x approaching to 0 sine x over x equal to 1 and limit x approaching to 0 1 minus cos x over x equal to 0. Okay, so kat sini ni sama. Here x, here also x. If over there is 2x, so sine 2x, so denominator also 2x. Okay, so this one is equal to 1. Okay, so same for this one also, sine 3x over 3x, so this one also 1. Okay, so dia kena sama, 2x, 2x, 3x, 3x, 4x, 4x. Okay, so dia kena sama. Okay, so and one more here, yang dekat dalam sign ni. So limit x approaching to 0, let's say sin 3x over x. Okay, so ni kita ada 3x di dalam sign. Okay, so yang ni kita tak boleh ubah apa-apa. Sin ni tak boleh ubah apa-apa. So dia boleh ubah sekiranya gunakan trigonometric identities. So identity yang korang belajar dulu masa pre-calculus. Okay, so kalau ada identities boleh ubah. So tapi ni tak boleh ubah. Okay, so tak boleh bawa 3 ni keluar. Okay, semata-mata untuk jadikan sin x over x. Okay, so contoh So 3 limit 3 sin x over x. Okay, so ni salah. Okay, so 3 kat luar ni, ni salah, sangat salah. Okay, memang kosong. Okay, kalau buat macam ni jawapan. Okay, markah kosong, jawapan kosong. So markah kosong. Okay, so example kita tengok sini. So limit x approaching to 0 sin 2x over 3x. So if you substitute 0, so you will have 0 over 0. Okay, 2 times 0, 0, 3 times 0, 0. So sin 0 is 0, so 0 over 0. Okay, okay, so what you need to do, so you need to use the properties of trigonometric tadi tu. Okay, so yang sin x over x equal to 1. Okay, so tapi macam mana nak pakai? So sini here 2x, but here 3x. Okay, so kita kena samakan lah. So yang bawah ni kena jadi 2x. So to become 2x, what we need to do? So multiply with 2. So since denominator multiply with 2, numerator times by 2. So we have here limit x approaching to 0 2 sin 2x over 3 times 2x. Okay, so 3x darab 2 ni kita boleh buat 3 darab 2x. Okay, Okay, so tak payah darabkan 3 dengan 2 jadi 6. Tak payah, okay? Tulis je macam ni. Sebab kita nak here to x and here also to x. Okay, so for this one, so since here multiplication, here also multiplication, so we can take out 2 over 3. Okay, so boleh bawa keluar 2 per 3. So 2 over 3 limit x approaching to 0 sin 2x over 2x. Okay, so since this one 2x, here also 2x, so therefore the limit x approaching 0, 0 this one is 1. So 2 over 3 times by 1. So the answer is 2 over 3. Okay, so, so dekat sini ni, ni ada 2 per 3. Tak boleh ke kita terus keluarkan je? Jadi macam ni, 2 sin x over 3x. So ni bukan jadi sin x over x ke sih? Betul, memang jadi sin x over x. Tapi ni konsep dia ni salah. Awak buat keluar 2 ni salah, okay? So this one wrong. Mana boleh buat keluar 2 ni? So 2x ni dekat dalam sin, so tak boleh bawa keluar, okay? So cannot, tak boleh bawa keluar, okay? So this one wrong, okay? Okay, so another example. Okay, so this one tan x over x. Okay, so if you substitute 0 and calculate, so you will have tan 0 over 0, which is 0 over 0. So therefore we need to use limit x approaching to 0 sin x over x, which is equal to 1. Tapi sir, mana ada sin? Kat sini ada tan je. Ya, betul. So what is the meaning of tan? So tangent is sin over cos. Okay, so sin x over cos x, and then divide with x. Okay, so it is equal to limit x approaching to 0 sin x over cos x times by, so this x is, this x actually over 1. Okay, so boleh terbalikkan, 1 over x. So it is equal to limit x approaching to 0, so sin x over x cos x. So we have two things here, sin x over x and 1 over cos x. Okay. Okay, so this one, it is equal to limit x approaching to 0 sin x over x times with 1 over cos x. Okay, so satu ni boleh wujudkan apa-apa lah. Sebab apa-apa nombor, apa-apa benda, kita boleh darabkan dengan satu. Okay, untuk darab, okay? Kalau tambah, tak adalah nak tambah-tambah, tiba-tiba tambah satu, okay? Tak boleh. Okay, so then since here multiplication, so we can do limit sin x over x, x approaching to 0 times with limit x approaching to 0 1 over cos x. So it is equal to, for the first one is 1 times by 1 over cos 0. So cos 0 is 1. So 1 divided by 1 is 1. So 1 times by 1 is 1. Okay, so jawab 1. Okay, so another example. So 3y over 4y. Sin. So this one also we will use limit x approaching to 0 sin 3y pula sin x over x equal to 1. Tapi sini y, so kat sini y lah, so y approaching to 0, here y, y. Okay, so if 3y, okay? So tapi kat sini kita tak ada pun sebawah ni y. Macam mana tu? Okay? Macam mana nak buat? Okay, so kita boleh buat macam ni. So ada atas dengan bawah. Sin 3y. Okay, so yang atas ni actually over 1. Bawah pun kita boleh buat sin 4y over 1. Okay. Okay, so apa-apa nombor kita boleh per dengan 1. Contoh kalau 2. So 2 sama dengan 2 per 1. Okay. Sin x. It is also equal to sin x over 1. So dia boleh per 1. Okay, so saya buat per 1 sebab apa? Sebab nak ni lah. Sebab saya nakkan yang ni. Okay, and then okay, so yang bawah ni kena ada 3y. Okay, so times 3y. And then yang atas ni pun times with 3y. Okay, so ni pun sama, times by 4y. So yang atas ni pun times by 4y. So we have here limit y approaching to 0, 3y sin 3y over 3y, and then divide by, kemana pula dia pergi? Okay, and then divide by, so yang ni yang pecahan ni jadi bahagi sin. Okay, so 4y sin 4y over 4y. Okay, seterusnya, seterusnya apa kita boleh buat? Okay, so this one nanti kita boleh jadikan 1. This one also become 1. So since you divide, so it is equal to 3y sin 3y over 3y times with 4y over sin 4y. Kat sini ada 4y tertinggal depan dia. Okay, so 4y sin 4y. Okay, so ni jadi 1. Yang ni pun nanti akan jadi 1. So, tapi terbalik, tak apa, tak ada masalah. Okay, so kalau dia terbalik pun tak ada masalah. Okay, so dia jadi 1. Okay, so sekarang ni here 3y. Dia dekat atas, yang ni dekat bawah. So y ni kita boleh cancel. Okay, so what we have here, limit y approaching to 0. Okay, so sini darab, 4 ni kita boleh bawa ke hadapan. So we have 3 over 4. So 3 over 4 times with sin 3y over 3y, and then times with 4y over sin 4y. So the answer is 3 over 4 times with 1 and times with 1. Sebab yang ni 1, yang ni pun 1. Okay, so the answer is 3 over 4. Okay, so I call this one. So this equal to, okay, so if you substitute 0, so this one so will become 0 over 0. So 4 times 0 minus sin 2 times 0 is 0 over 4 times 0. So which is 0 over 0. Okay, so what you need to do, okay, so bahagi, split into 2. So limit x approaching to 0, 4x square over 4x minus sin 2x over 4x. Okay, and then it is equal to limit x approaching to 0, so 4x square divided by 4x, so the answer is x minus, so sini 2x, so bawah pun kita nak 2x. So bawah ni perlu kita darab 2? Tak perlu, because 4x actually is 2 times with 2x. Okay, so we have here limit x approaching to 0x minus by limit x approaching to 0, so 1 over 2 times with sin x over 2x. Okay, So sini 1 per 2. Okay, so saya pecahkan over 2 times sin 2x over 2x. So the answer is, for the first one is 0 minus, so this one is 1, 1 over 2 times with 1. So the answer is negative 1 over 2. Okay, next, another example. So limit x approaching to 0, sin 3x over x, 1 plus cos 3x. Okay, so if you substitute 0, so become sin 3 times 0, 0 over 0 times 1 plus cos 0. Okay, so sin 0 is 0, and then 0 times anything, the answer is 0. So 0 over 0. Okay, so kita kena guna properties tu lah. Okay, so this one, it is equal to limit x approaching to 0 sin 3x over x. Okay, so here multiplication. So saya boleh pecahkan times with 1 over 1 plus cos 3x. Okay, so saya boleh pecahkan. Saya sebut 3x, saya tulis x3 pula. Okay, so 3x. Okay, so it is equal to limit x approaching to 0 sin 2 over x times with limit x approaching to 0 1 over 1 plus cos 3x. Okay, so sini 2x, sini x. Okay, so yang bawah ni kita kena darabkan dengan 2. So times with 2 numerator, so times with 2. So we have here limit x approaching to 0 2 times with sin 2x over 2x times with, hilang lagi. Okay, so limit x approaching 0, so this one, okay, so boleh kira terus. So 1 over 1 plus cos 3 times 0 is 0. Okay, so the answer is, so this one is 1. So 2 times with 1, and then times 1 over cos 0 is 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. So the answer is 1. Okay, so 2 darab 1, 2. 2 darab 1 per 2, 1. Okay, so ada lagi tak? Okay, ada lagi. So this one also, if you substitute 0, so you will have 0 cos 0 minus sin 5 times 0 over 0. Okay, so 0 minus 0 over 0, which is 0 over 0. Okay, okay, so what you need to do for this one, so kena guna properties tadi tu lah. Tapi kat sini dia jadi ada tolak ni. Okay, so apa yang kita kena buat, split into 2. So limit x approaching to 0 x cos x over x minus sin 5x over x. So it is equal to limit x approaching to 0 x over x cancel, so the only left is cos x and then minus. So tolak sini, limit ni kita boleh letak kat depan lagi satu. Okay, so yang ni properties of limit yang mula-mula dulu belajar. So kalau tambah macam mana, tolak macam mana, darab macam mana. Okay, so it is equal to, so yang depan ni boleh kira lah cos 0. Okay, so yang belakang, so since here 1 and here 5, so denominator times by 5, numerator also times by 5. So minus by limit x approaching to 0 5 sin 5x over 5x. Okay, so this one become 1. So therefore the answer is cos 0 is 1 minus 5, so 5 yang ni, okay, so 5 times with 1, okay, so the answer is negative 4. Okay, so ada lagi? Tak ada. Okay, okay, so that's all for our lesson today. So see you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.